Alright, so before I start working on our lovely Jessica, this is actually how I bought her. This video was filmed before Christmas, way before the release video. So I wanted to show you guys how I got her and what has been done to her. Start off with the wheels, of course. These are nubbies. I have her on this pallet thingy right now. Because my MX stand isn't in yet, so that's a thing, yeah, but it works. So wheels, front and rear, the brake rotor protector, the headlight probably, front fender, the ignition is a simple push button right now, so that's not that cool. I don't know if I did that, but it's probably with a key right now. So grips, hand, levers, front and rear, indicators, non-existent, rear fender needs to be changed out. Exhaust, I'm gonna keep that one stock for now, aero exhaust. I don't know what else I'm probably gonna change out. Maybe the tank, plastics, I have new plastics for it. I did have a new front fender too, but because it's a long one like this one, it's exactly the same just without the stickers. I'm not gonna put it on there because with these supermoto wheels, which I got on Friday, that's gonna look pretty stupid with the long stuff on here. So I ordered a short one, but it isn't in yet. Same as with the stand. So yeah, I'm gonna get to mounting these wheels and do all the other fun stuff. So this is the video in which I explain everything what has been done and changed on Jessica from the moment I got her up until now, the finished product. So first off, I got the wheels like almost the same week, bought the bike on Monday, had it brought here on Thursday, and Friday I went for wheels. They're secondhand Excel rims with talon hubs in a gorgeous blue, with some tires on it I don't really like. Gold speed Maxxis. Don't like the pattern. Want something more like a race tire, but still with some grooves in it. But whatever, it's good for now. And swapped out the front guards with white ones because the blue ones were pretty worn out. The rims didn't come with a front brake disc, so I got a Motomaster's 270mm front brake disc with a braking experience, or braking is the brand, what do you call that bracket to put the man, my English is bad today. What's the thing called? The caliper. A little more bag because the disc is bigger. So I got that done. Got the shorty front fender in white instead of the blue long ones. Got a Racetech V-Phase LED front headlight with LEDs in there. And I rigged these up to the key ignition, so when I turn the key on, these will light up. I didn't bring the key, so can't show you that. Did I? I brought the key. I did bring the key. Alright, cool. So, key ignition right here, which is a bit tricky, especially with gloves on. If you turn this on, the LEDs light up, as well with the neutral light right here on my vapor gauge with the little dashboard around it. Got the neutral light, high beams and indicators. Also still have the original push button for the ignition, which is handy to turn it off or something. But we've got that light, and this thing has a low beam and high beam in the same housing, which is pretty nice. I installed indicators on it because she didn't come with indicators whatsoever. There was absolutely nothing. Not the switch here, which I also had to install together with the high beam selector. The horn isn't attached. There's no horn on Jessica, so I'll just have to rev it. But this thing, this block right here, wasn't installed. There was no wiring on the bike, there was no relay, like the blinker thing on it. There were no indicators, no wiring, nothing. I had to install that all myself. But it works, and it works fantastic. I'm really happy with that. They look great as well. Some say it might look like a Christmas ornament, but I don't give a shit, man. I don't give a shit. Swapped out the grips because the old ones were worn. But these actually came with the bike, so it was just easy to install that. Got the trail tech paper, the key switch thingy. I swapped the front, what do you call that, radiator protector guards. Of course, with the sticker set on there, which is looking fucking amazing. I've got the Pro Carbon Racing carbon front sprocket protector, or whatever that's called. There was no protector on there, and I was told that it's not a big deal, like my trousers wouldn't get caught in it, but I didn't really trust it, so I went ahead and got that one. This is pretty nice. I made a custom kickstand. This is from an old drive shaft of a car that had laying around at work. Some welds and a little bit of paint, and this is what you end up with. And why I did this is because the original dirt wheels with the 21 inch on the front made the bike sit up a little bit higher, and the kickstand was longer. So on these little wheels, smaller wheels, the kickstand was too long, and the bike was standing like almost vertically upright, and a little breeze could just blow it over, which was not cool. Right, so moving on, let's change out the number plate boards. Those were also worn. Removed any stickers that were on there. Previously there were a few here, and there was some really annoying one on the rear swinging arm. Nothing swapped out there. The sprocket and rear brake disc on the rear wheel were already installed when I bought them. So that was pretty cool. Swapped out the rear fender, also with stickers on it. Mounted the indicators. The rear tail light, which was on the old old fender, had to swap that over. Let's see, what else did I do? Oh, and this monster can right here. This is an old monster can I just cut up with a little zip tie. Mounted it right there, so that was pretty cool. And yeah, I think that's about it. I didn't do anything to the engine, to the motor itself, because that one was fully rebuilt. It's got a new piston, crankshaft, ball bearings, and the valves were set. Valve clearance was set. So that was all running fine. She runs really well. And yeah, I think that's everything I've done to her in the past couple of months. I think totaling with all the wiring and electrical stuff that I put on, because on this Vapor trail track, you don't only have the speed, the time, the kilometers, the temperature, you also have the RPM. With the RPM bar graph, you have engine temperature, and you have total amount of time ridden, top speed, top RPM, maximum temperature, and all that shit, plus wiring up all these lights. It took a while to do all that. And then the indicator system, that was a biatch to mount. I think I spent like 6 or 7 hours on that to mount all that shit. So yeah, that's Jessica. This video is getting rather long, so I'll switch it off here. This is actually just me enjoying the new sticker set, because it's been installed for like 5 minutes. I spent another few hours on that one. So yeah, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Jessica. We do it for fun, yeah, yeah. We just do it.